We've seen the present tenses in isolation. Now let's look at them together. Our first example is, I play football every week. This is the present simple tense, and it has the structure subject, I, plus verb, play. This is quite a simple tense for students to form. However, they have to be aware of the third person singular form, he, she, or it, which usually adds an S or an ES onto the end of the base form of the verb. I play football, but he plays football. Also, the question and negative forms using the auxiliary verb do or does. Do you play football? I don't play football. Does she play football? She doesn't play football. The present simple tense is used to talk about habits, routines, facts, and general truths. And as such, it's probably the most commonly used tense within the English language. Our second example sentence, I am playing football at the moment, is the present continuous tense. This has a different structure. It has the subject, I, the verb to be in the present tense, am, is, or are, plus the verb with an ing on the end. So here, I am playing football at the moment. Whereas the present simple tense is used to talk about habits, routines, and facts, the present continuous tense is used to talk about actions in progress at the time of speaking or around the time of speaking. Our third example sentence is the present perfect. I have played football twice this week. Here the structure is the subject, I, auxiliary verb, have or has, plus the past participle. The past participle is usually formed just by adding ed onto the end of the base form of the verb. However, students need to be aware of the many irregular verbs, such as know would change to known, go to gone, understand to understood, and so on. Unfortunately, there are no rules for this, and they just have to be learnt individually. The present perfect always relates the past to the present. This can be through the unfinished past, where we're expressing duration, such as, I have played football for 10 years. The indefinite past, expressing experience in your life, such as, I have been to Italy and Spain. And also, to show the present result of a past action. I have broken my leg. I broke it in the past, and it remains broken in the present. Our final present tense is the present perfect continuous tense. Our example sentence here, I have been playing football for 10 years, has the structure subject plus auxiliary verb have or has, and then a second auxiliary verb, here been, plus verb ing, I have been playing. Very much like the present perfect tense, the present perfect continuous relates the past to the present, but more focus on the continuity or the duration of the action. It can also be used to express the unfinished past, such as the example here, I have been playing football for 10 years, an action that began in the past and still continues in the present. We can see that this particular usage of the unfinished past can be used for both the present perfect and the present perfect continuous. Where we've got action verbs, we usually prefer to use the present perfect continuous. However, there are state verbs which don't usually go into the continuous form, such as know. We would say, I have known her for 10 years, not I have been knowing her for 10 years. So when we have these state verbs, such as know, be, seem, and appear, we would usually put these in the present perfect. But with the action verbs, such as play, cook, work, we will use these in the present perfect continuous normally. We also use the present perfect continuous fairly frequently with words such as just or recently to express a recently completed action with a present result. For example, I am tired because I have been playing football.